In this feature video, we're going to take a look at our new selection order, which is called Chunks. This is added in our 1.9.7 release and onwards, so let's take a look here. Chunks is a new way of selecting or sub-selecting fixtures. So if I take my group 4, which is my spots, Chunks, if I press and hold my odd even button over here on the right hand side, like so, you can see on my odd even toolbar, I have things like my usual odds and evens, so I can go into odds and evens. I have things like, if I go back to none here, I can go into segments, which allows me to take twos, threes, fours, or using ends, any number of segments I like. So segments, if I go into say segments of two, and I use next head, allows me to go and take two heads at a time and move along. Chunks allows a slightly different selection order. Of course, we have things like pairs as well. Chunks is a new one. If I go to chunks now, you can see when I select into chunks, I've got the option of twos, threes, fours, or ends, any number of chunks I like for larger selections. And what it's doing is it's allowing quick selections of parts of the rig. So you can see I've got 12 spots in two chunks, it's split in two, the left side and the right side. If I go into three chunks, it splits, you know, first one, two, three, like so. So it's slightly different to segments and how it works. It's splitting by the selection order. So with our new feature, which is linked groups, which is also in 1.9.7, if I go into say two chunks and I record this as a group here, and then I hit next and I record there, you can see it makes my chunk groups, which are linked back to my master group. If I go and hold odd even, I can go into different number of chunks. I can go into three chunks and I can go and record first one there, next record there, next record there. And you can see when I select these groups, it selects the chunks of fixtures. Now, the chunks would dynamically be updated based on the order of my linked groups. So if I took, say, chunk three, which is four heads at the end here, or the last chunk, and I set, say, a color on those, let's say magenta, and I store that as a cue here. If I was to go and update the master group, I'm just going to take a quick copy of it here. If I was to take the master group, and in fact, I'm going to remove three heads out, I'm going to take two from the end and one there, so you can see in highlighted in red the new selection of heads here. I'm going to re-record my master group like so, record, select, yes, and you can see there's now nine heads in there. If I run this queue, and I could have the queue running active at the time, I don't have to reassert it, you can see the chunk has been updated. There's now only nine heads, so rather than 12 being in there, I'm in chunks of threes, not fours, and you can see as I select the groups, one, two, three, and it's taken out those three heads. So it's recalculated what should be in that chunk as well. So it will dynamically update my programming. So chunks is a nice way of selecting or sub-selecting groups, fixtures, but we can also use chunks and effects now in version 1.9.7. So if I take my spots group at the top here, I'm going to re-record and put all the spots back in, like so, and select, and I'm going to just go and add an effect, and I'm going to say intensity, and I'm going to put a basic dimmer chase on. And I'm going to go and wind the width down a little bit to say 30%. If I take my segments control on the right hand side and wind up the segments and keep going up, it'll turn into chunks. When I've turned segments to chunks here, my parts control turns into my chunk numbers. And you can see at the moment it's at none, so it's just coming on and off as a single chunk. If I change that to two, you can see it's now split into two chunks. If I speed that up a little bit, there you go, you can see it's coming on as two chunks. I'm going to store this as a queue here. Now I'm going to split into three chunks, record that as a queue, and another one as four chunks. There you go, one, two, three, four, you can see there. And I'm going to store that as a queue as well. And this works with both group queues and normal head queues and effects as well. So I'm using group effects at the moment, but this would work with normal effects as well using chunk selection. Of course, the power of group queues. This is a bit linked back to my master group, group four. So you can see there's my first queue. If I set this to queue timing, yes. There's my first queue. There's second queue, which is in three chunks, and the fourth one, which is in four chunks. Of course, this is all linked back to group four. This is a group queue. So if you're not using group queues, obviously it won't affect your group effect when you go and update the contents of group later. It would just be used for actual recording based on heads. But of course, using group queues and group effects now, if I go and change the contents of this group again, so I'm going to go and take out, say, the first head, someone in the middle there, and that one there, these three heads here. So I'm going to go back to nine again, and I'm going to re-record this group like so. You can see it's real-time updated my effect that's running. If I go back to the first queue, which is chunks of two, The new group has 9 in, which is clearly an odd number, so it's doing a 5 and a 4, but you can see it's split left and right. It's updated the heads it's using based on the selection order that's now in my group 4. And if I press next, this is going to be my chunks of 3. 1, 2, 3, there you go, and you can see again it's updated the selection order. And if I go to chunks of 4, again, 9 isn't divisible by 4, so it takes the best it can do, 4, 3, and so on there, as you can see there. So that's chunks available in our MagicQ 197 release. Download it now.